Hey guys, I wanted to make a quick demo of a couple of plugins, a couple of my favorite plugins to use for Roving Threats. I didn't make these plugins, but they're very useful, and I like to get people to use them whenever I can because it makes it a lot easier to scout for Roving Threats, and it helps a lot when you're actually leading a raid to go kill the Roving Threats too. So the name of the two plugins I'm gonna show are RTPlugin and Waypoint. I've already got them installed on my machine. I'll put some links in the low bar so you can install them. But if you go to your plugin manager, you can load them this way. So I'll load the RTPlugin. When it loads, you can see that it makes a little icon here. The other plugin is Waypoint. And I'm going to demonstrate Waypoint first because it's simpler, but they both work together. And I'll show how you do that. So with Waypoint, the main idea of that plugin is if you want to find your way to a certain point on the map, say I want to get to this point here, which is 25.4 south by 53.9 west, then I can enter a command in the chat window here. Tell it the target where you want to go, which .4 south, 53.9 west. And then when you hit enter, this little arrow comes up, which every time you click on it, it will update. It won't update if you don't click on it, but when you click on it, it updates and it points in the direction you need to go to get to the point that you selected, and it tells you how far away it is. So, as I ride in that direction, as long as I keep clicking to update it, and I keep the arrow pointing up towards the top of the screen, then I'm going directly toward my destination. You can see the distance getting lower. So the way this helps with Roving Threats is if you know where the Roving Threats are and you want to be able to quickly navigate between them, like if you're leading a raid, this helps. And there's the traveling vendor right there. Okay, so the other plugin I'm going to show is RTPlugin. Once you have it loaded, you've got this icon on your screen. If you click on it, it'll show you a map. Along the top here, you've got tabs showing all the regions that have Roving Threats in them. Angmar, Evendim, Forestal. And then for each of the regions, it shows the points on the map where there can be Roving Threats. Every day at 3 a.m. server time, the Roving Threats move. So for example, if you've got four Roving Threats in Forest Shell, and so every day at 3 a.m. it's going to choose four of these points where the Roving Threats will spawn for that day, and if you kill them, they just respawn in the same place 5 minutes later. This has got a map for each region, and what you do is you ride from one point to the other, and as you find one, you just click on that to mark it, and then once you've found all of the Roving Threats for that region, You can click the lock icon so you're not accidentally changing it. So let's go to Mirkwood, and I'll show you how I would use this plugin to scout a region. By the way, if you want to close this waypoint, just click on that plus sign. Okay, so we're here in Mirkwood. Another nice feature of this plugin, if you click on this green dot here, it'll show you where you are on the map. So I'm right here. So first thing I want to do is scout this point here. So in order to, this is the nice integration between this plugin and Waypoint. I don't have to actually enter the command when I'm to use Waypoint, because this plugin will do it for me. RTPlugin will do it for me. If you hold down the Alt key, you can see all the dots turn blue. And if you click on one, then it will enter the command for you to set the target for Waypoint. So I'm going to Alt left click on this point. And now you can see it has set the Waypoint target to that point. Now in this particular case, I cannot go directly, excuse me, I can't go directly toward that destination, because in order to get there I have to go out through this gate and then go around there. So that's the gate over there. Hang a left. Now I'm gonna go straight toward the spawn point over here. And there's nothing here. I would be able to see it if I'm standing right at the spawn point and I look all around, because I've got my object draw distance set to maximum. The roving threats don't move very far off of their spawn points. Certainly if you get right on the actual spawn point, so it says now I've arrived at that exactly at the spawn point, then you should be able to see it. I'm just looking around you. But there's nothing here. So now I'm gonna Alt click on this next point and just ride directly up to it. Say directly, but this is Mirkwood, so I'll be lucky if there is a direct path. Okay, so here we are. And there's nothing here either, so on to the next one. Depending on the region and the number of spawn points, it will take you 10 or 15 minutes to scout the whole region. If you get lucky and you find all of the roving threats before you've scouted the whole thing, it can take less time, but once you get some practice, it should never take more than 15 minutes. And there's a wood weaver, a giant spider. So we found a roving threat at this point. I'm gonna mark it in red there. And then I would just go on to scout all the rest of these points over here. There's usually, pretty much every day, there's one in this in the castle here. But the rest of the spawn locations are pretty much random, since there's four roving threats in this region. I just found one. That means there's got to be three more among these remaining points here. One of them is probably in the castle there. So the other major cool feature of this plugin is that you can share the points with another player. So you can help scout regions, you know, you can share the scouting duties easily. So I'm going to show how to do that. Got another character logged in. Over here. Make a braid. I gotta load the plugin over here. I was playing this earlier, so we already got some points rolled in over here. Okay, so suppose I found a roving threat here. And then here and here. And I want to send that information to someone else who has this plugin. The way you can do that is just with these buttons on here. If I want to send information to a particular person, I just choose tell in this pull down menu here, put in their name, click send. And now all the points have immediately appeared on our map. There it is. Yeah, so you can see it sent the information through tell here. If you don't want anyone messing with if you've already done scouting and you don't want anyone to be able to troll you and mess up your map, then you can uncheck this checkbox. And then if I try to send you something, it's not going to update your map. You can also send the information to these to other channels, you know, your raid or even the world channel, so anyone who's listening on the world channel can get the points. So the next day when you're ready to scout the region again, you can click this button to reset all the points on the map. But that these changes only work if you have the map unlocked. So if you're through scouting for the day and you don't want to accidentally reset, you don't want to be able to receive any data, you can just lock the map. So and one other feature that you can use when you're actually doing a raid and telling people where to go is you can, I told you that you could alt click on here to set the waypoint target, which you can see here, it's halfway off the screen. But you can also control click. If you hold down the control key, everything turns yellow, and then if you left click, it will send a message to, oops, I just sent that to the world channel, but let's see, my raid, I'm gonna send a notice to the raid that says next roving threat is at this location. So if I just left click on the next place, control left click on the next place I'm gonna go, and then alt left click to set up waypoint, and then off I go. And so that's the way I do it when I'm leading a roving threat raid, and I can go directly from one point to the next without wasting a lot of time. Okay, so that's all I wanted to show you with these. I'll put some links in the low bar for how to find these plugins. There's also a nice program called Plugin Compendium that will make it easy to install them. It's easy to install them manually, but it's even easier with Plugin Compendium, so I'll put a link to that as well. Okay, hope you guys found this useful. Talk to you later.